Hello, once again, our viewers. We are back, science education consultants. Consultants in math, physics, biology, and chemistry for both O and A level. We do online coaching, guidance and counseling, and career guidance. I am called Teacher Ison Naisha, a teacher of physics and math. But specifically today, I welcome you to lesson 5 of our O-level mathematics. We have been previously talking about matrices, where we talked about operation of matrices, that is addition, subtraction, and multiplication. We talked about identity matrix, and we talked about the determinant of a matrix. Today, we're gonna switch to an inverse of a matrix. The inverse of a matrix. Of a matrix A is denoted by A inverse. If we have the matrix A, then to say the inverse of A, we write A our negative 1. And it is given by A inverse equaling to 1 over determinant of A times the adjoint of A. What is the adjoint or the adjoint of a matrix? The adjoint or adjoint of a matrix is a matrix which is got by interchanging the elements in the major diagonal and then changing the signs in the minor, or of the elements in the minor diagonal. The adjoint of a matrix minor diagonal. We shall see that. We talked about the matrix previously and gave it two diagonals, the major and the minor. If you are able to identify those two diagonals, then the adjoint or adjoint will not be hard for you. Assume a matrix A which is equal to A, B, C. Then the major diagonal is this and the minor diagonal is this. This is the minor. To get the adjoint or the adjoint of A, I can abbreviate it as adj of A. It will be given by interchanging A and B, and so we come along the major and the minor. Where there is A, we put D. Where there is B, we put A. Where there is B along the minor diagonal, we put a negative B. And where there is a positive C, we put a negative C. So the adjoint of A is D negative C negative B. A. Interchanging the elements in the major and the changing the signs in the minor diagonal. This simply means that if we are able to compute the determinant of A from the previous lesson by multiplying the elements in the major minus the product of elements in the minor, that is AD minus BC. We can simply say that A inverse therefore equals 1 divided by the determinant, that is AD minus BC, into the adjoint, which is D negative C negative B A. That is all. Examples. Number 1, find A inverse. They have given us a matrix and they want us to compute the inverse of A. I said the step number 1, to be able to compute the inverse, we must be knowing the determinant. What is the determinant of A. The determinant of A is equal to the product of this, which is negative 4 times negative 2. Then you subtract 3 times 2. And this simply gives you a positive 8 minus 6, that is a 2. If you are able to do that, what is the adjoint of A? The adjoint of A. The adjoint of A is what? By interchanging these elements, meaning that negative 2 will go up and negative 4 down, then the signs of these will change. This will become a negative 3, this will become a negative 2. From there, we shall simply say that A inverse equals 1 over determinant, the determinant is 2, into the adjoint, which is negative 2, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4. And this goes inside, and we say a half times that, that is a half times negative 2, a half times negative 2, a half times negative 3, a half times negative 4. Multiplying the scalar in the matrix, we talked about it. This simply gives you negative 1, negative 1. Negative 3 over 2 is negative 1.5, and this is negative 2. That is an inverse of A. Being able to determine the determinant of a matrix and an inverse of a matrix, we can switch on to another concept or type of the matrix, which we call a singular matrix. A singular matrix. We say a matrix is singular. Oh, this is a singular matrix. If and only if it has the determinant as zero. If the determinant of a matrix is zero, then that matrix is a singular matrix. And we say that that matrix has no inverse. Why? Because an inverse of a matrix, let's say A, is given by 1 out of determinant of A into the adjoint of A. And if the determinant is 0, it implies that we shall have 1 over 0 into adjoint of A. Whatever the value of adjoint of A, this will be undefined because 1 over 0 is undefined. So we are saying a singular matrix has determinant as 0. That is point number. Point number 2. It has no inverse. It now comes as an example. Show that is singular. Is singular. And we are calculating equal to 4, 8, 36. Then the determinant of A, the determinant of A will be equal to product of this, which is 4 times 6, then minus product of this, which is 3 times 8. And this simply gives you 24 minus 24, which is a 0. And since the determinant is 0, since the determinant is 0, is 0, comma, it is a singular matrix. It is a singular matrix. That is all. Now, being able to define the a singular matrix and an inverse of a matrix, we can have a simple activity. Number one. Form R2. Let me call it number one. Form R2 by 2 matrix of your form. Part B. Compute its determinant. Part C. Compute its adjoint. And part D,
find its inverse.
Number two.
Given that
such that matrix A is a singular matrix.
Your ability to do this, you have known to compute the determinant of a matrix, the adjoint and its inverse, as well as showing whether the matrix is singular or not. We are BackSense Education Consultants,
and we are ready to serve you under all circumstances. Subscribe to our YouTube channel, BackSense Education Consultants, and follow our online classes for both O and A level. Science is a key to success. Thank you very much.